Hi everyone, I am the founder of the Gray Blind Owl. As I said before in the previous lesson, we will do some exercises about arrays, matrices, and functions in this lesson. The first one, instructions. We will write a function that takes an array and returns minimum element and its index. For example, our array is 2, 3, 1, 7, 3. So our function has to return us minimum element 1 and its index 2. If two or more elements have the same value as a minimum point, returning one of them is okay. We include our library, hashtag include stdio.h. We create a prototype for our function here, integer, minimum, finder, integer pointer, integer and integer pointer, and semicolon. This is our prototype. Now, we create our main function, integer main. We create some variables here. I for counter, limit for the element number, and index for element order, minimum for the minimum element, and integer I limit index minimum, and semicolon. We create an array here, array 20. Okay, integer, array 20, and semicolon. Everything is okay now. Now, we want the user to enter how many numbers he or she wants to enter. Printf, please enter how many numbers you want to enter. Scanf, the person sign D, ampersand, limit. Execute, compile, and run. Here, please enter how many numbers you want to enter. I will enter here 5, and I will enter these numbers 2, 3, 1, 7, 3. As you can see, minimum item is equal to 1 and its index is equal to 2. Here, minimum element 1 and its index 2. Okay. We get the numbers here. Please enter the numbers. For I is equal to 0, I is less than limit, and I plus plus, scan of the person sign D, ampersand, array I. This part, 2, 3, 1, 7, 3. And now we send our array, the limit value, and the minimum variable to our function. Okay? We send the array, the limit value, and the minimum variable. Here, ampersand array 0, the first element's address. We can do this like that, but we use this usage generally. But I want to show that ampersand array 0. This is okay, this is legal. We can use also this, but we use generally this one, only the name. Okay, but I only want to show that. Okay, index is equal to minimum finder array limit and the ampersand minimum. We have two variables that we want to change. One of them index, but our function returns this value to our main function here. This is okay. Also, we use the address of minimum because I want to change minimum value. Okay, but I cannot return two variables or two values. Okay, so I have to use address of minimum. Okay, that is why we use address of minimum. I want to change this one. Okay, I cannot return this variable because I return an index value here, but I want to also change minimum value. So I send its address to our function. Okay, now this is our function, integer minimum finder. integer pointer array, integer pointer array, integer limit value, and integer address of reference minimum. Okay, integer I and index is equal to 0. We set the first element as the minimum, and reference minimum is equal to array 0. We use this variable like that because I want to change my minimum, but in this function, in integer main function. So we use the referenced value. We create a for loop and compare our minimum with the next element in sequence. We start our loop from the second element because we have chosen the first element to be minimal here. We choose the first element to be minimal. So we start our for loop from the second element. So I is equal to 1. I is equal to I is not equal to 0. Okay. For I is equal to 1 and I is less than limit and I plus plus. Now, if our array element is smaller than our minimum value, we select it as the new minimum and save our counter as index. Like that. If array I, array index, is less than minimum. So our second element is less than our first element. Do that. The reference minimum is equal to array I because our second element is less than our first element. And we put this value into this value. Okay? Into this value. We can also use this usage, reference array plus I, and we prefer this one in this section. And index is equal to I. Okay, index is equal to I. We select it as the new minimum here, and save our counter as index. Save our counter as index. If it is not, you do not have to do anything. Okay, if here is not, we cannot do anything here. We do not have to do anything. And we return our index to our main function here, return index, and go to our main function here. Now index value and this index was put into this index, and our minimum value has changed here or here because we used it with reference. Okay, we print the minimum item and its index on the screen. Printf minimum item, the person sign D represents minimum, and index, the person sign D represents index, and semicolon. We finish our program here, return 0. As you can see, minimum item 1 and its index is equal to 2. That was the first part. Now the second one here, instructions. We will write a function that takes an array and calculates the frequencies of the numbers within a given array. We suppose each element have one digit, so not bigger than 9. For example, our array is 1, 2, 5, 2, 9, 8, 1, 2. So our frequencies are like that, 0, 0, 1, 2, here, 1 and 1, and 2, 3. 2, 2, 2. There are 3 times 2. And 3, 0. 4, 0. 5, 1. Here. 5. 6, 0. 7, 0, 8, 1. Here, 8, 1. And 9, 1. Here, 9, 1. Okay, do not forget that our array has to consist of one-digit numbers. This is the critical point. Okay, we include our library. Hashtag include stdio.h. We create a prototype for our function void calculate integer pointer and integer and semicolon. We create our main function here, integer main, the brackets and the curly brackets. Now we create some variables here. I for counter and limit for element number, integer I and limit and semicolon. And now we create an array. Array 20 and here integer array 20 and semicolon. This is the classical part. And everything is okay now. We want the user to enter how many numbers he or she wants to enter. And after that, we get the numbers here. Printf, please enter the numbers for I is equal to 0, I is less than limit, and I plus plus scanf the person sign D ampersand array I. And we are here now. Execute, compile, and run. Limit undeclared. Limit. Now, we are here now. Please enter how many numbers you want to enter. I will enter here. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. I will enter here 8. And please enter the numbers 1, 2, 5, 2, 9, 8, 1, 2. Here. 0, 0, 1, 2. Because 1 here and 1 here. There are 2 times 1. And 2, 3. 2, 2, 2. There are 3 times 2. 3, 0, 4, 0, 5, 1. Here, 5, 1. 6, 0, 7, 0, 8, 1. 8, 1. And 9, 1. 9 here, 1. Now, we send our array and the limit value to our main function. Calculate array, our array, and our limit value. That's it. Not too much parameters. And calculate array limit. We are here. We are here. Void calculate integer pointer array and integer limit. Our array is here and our limit value is here. Now initializes the array with zeros static with the static. We do this operation with the static. Static integer counter 10 initializes the array with zeros with the static usage. Okay, with the static usage initializes the array with zeros. We need an alternative array because we put the values into this array. We put the values into this array. Here, counter item plus plus. We use this array for the frequencies of the numbers. Okay, we create two counters, integer I and item and semicolon. We put our element into item and after that we increase our counter item to count the recurrent numbers. Okay, after that we increase our counter item to count the recurrent numbers. Here for i is equal to zero, I is less than limit, and I plus plus, item is equal to array I and semicolon, counter item plus plus. Here if our item is equal to array I, array I put into this value every repetition, and our item put into this array as an index, okay, as an index, and counter item plus plus. So for example, item is equal to 2 now, okay, item is equal to 2 now, and now counter 2 plus plus, so 2 is equal to 1. Now again, item is equal to 3 now, counter 3 is equal to 1. Now again, item is equal to 2 again, okay, item is equal to 2 again here, counter 2 plus plus, so our 2 is equal to 2 now. And now we print our result table for I is equal to 0, I is less than 10, and I plus plus. Printf, the person sign D, our counter, and the person sign D, our counter array I. Okay, counter array I. And our result here. Also, we can use this method. This one is an alternative method. We create and send our counter array in the main function. We do not create this counter array here. We create this array in this function, in our main function. And static int counter 10. Calculate alternative array limit and counter. Okay, after that our function here, we do the same job here, but we do not print this counter in this section. We print it our main function like that, and we finish our program here, return 0. That was the second part. Now, the last part. And the third part, actually. Instructions. We will write a function that calculates and returns the transpose of a given matrix. For example, our matrix is here. Matrix 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, the first row, and 4, 5, 6, second row. So our matrix transpose is matrix 3, 2, 1, 4, 2, 5, and 3, 6. Okay. Do not forget that since arrays and matrices are addressed to functions, the changes made appear on the main function as well. Okay. Since arrays and matrices are addressed to functions, the changes made appear on the main function as well. Okay. Now, we include our library here, hashtag include std io.h. We create our main functions here, so we do not use prototypes. We do not use prototypes because I create our functions above our main function, okay? So we do not have to use prototypes. I do this for the first time and the last time, and I want to show you this usage only, okay? This is not completely true. This is looks like confusing. So we do not use this usage generally. Okay. Void transpose version A, integer matrix, integer transpose matrix, integer row, integer column, the first version, and transpose version B, integer pointer pointer matrix, integer pointer pointer transpose matrix, and integer row, integer column, and void print matrix. This is an extra function. You can do this operation in the main function, but I want to write a print function like that. Okay, integer matrix 50 and integer row, integer column. Now our main function here, we create our main function, integer main, the brackets and the curly brackets, We create some variables I and j for counters, row and column for the matrix dimensions, integer I, j, row and column, semicolon. We create our matrix and its transpose, integer matrix 50 and 50, transpose matrix 50 and 50, and semicolon. We ask the user for the row and column numbers until proper ones are provided. Please give the row and column numbers of the matrix. Scanf the person sign D. This person sign D represents the ampersand row, and the person sign D represents ampersand column and semicolon. While row is bigger than 50 or column is bigger than 50, do that. We ask the user for the elements. Printf, please give the elements. For I is equal to 0, I is less than row and I plus plus. For j is equal to 0, j is less than column and j plus plus. Scanf the person sign D, ampersand matrix, I, j and semicolon. Now we prefer one of the functions that calculate the transpose. Transpose version A or transpose version B. Their parameters are the same. And you can prefer one of them. They are the same, but their methods are different. So I prefer the version B and transpose version B matrix, transpose matrix and row and column. I send these parameters to our function and semicolon. Now we are here. Matrix, transpose matrix, row and column. We create the counters for rows and columns, integer I and j, semicolon. Now we swap rows and columns with the alternative usage. You do not want to use this usage. You can use this method. Okay, you can use this method. But I want to use this method, so I preferred this version. Now I show this part on this line. This is so simple because transpose matrix row is J. As you can see, row is J, not I, and the column is I, not J. Inverse matrix I and J. Completely symmetrical. Okay, completely symmetrical. So transpose matrix, column, row, the classical matrix, row and column. They transferred their columns and rows. Okay. Now we are here. Print matrix function. We print our matrix and we print our transpose matrix. Matrix, row and column. Print matrix again, transpose matrix, column and row. As you can see, their row and column parameters are inverse. Column, row, row, column. Now let's try it. Execute, compile and run. Please give the row and column numbers of the matrix. I will enter here 2 and 3. Please give the elements 1, 2, 3 for the first row, 4, 5, 6 for the second row. As you can see, this is our classical matrix, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And this is our transpose matrix, 1, 4, 2, 5, and 3, 6. As you can see, the first row, our first column, and the second row, our second column now. Okay, that's it. We finish our program, return 0. That is it for this week. We did some exercises about arrays, matrices, and functions. Next week, we will learn how to make dynamic memory allocation, and with this achievement, we will be able to write more efficient programs that depend on users' data. You can find these exercises in the description part. Thanks for all your effort and your patience. See you following lecture. Stay tuned.